Let's look at the mid function. The mid function returns a string of text based on a start character and a number of characters that you want to return. The data that we have here is an inventory list that shows the item number right here, the 5-digit code, and then has an item name. So let's say that we wanted to create a column that has just the item number and just the item name. Now there are several ways of doing this in Excel, but we'll use the mid function in this case. So we'll type equals mid. And the first thing we need to give to this function is the text, which in this case would just be A2. Next, we need to give the start number. That's the start character within that text. Now it can get a little tricky trying to count how many characters within text that we want. You can actually go into the cell and just count the number of characters that you have. In this case though, item space number gives us 6 characters, and so we want to start with the 7th. So we're going to hit 7, and then the number of characters is the length of characters that you want. Because our item numbers are always 5 digits, we'll hit 5 right there, and close the parentheses, and our formula will return the correct item number. We can then pull that down to get the other item numbers as well. Now let's say that we wanted to return the item name, so we'll use the mid function again. The text is going to be that A2. The start number, again, you can go in and count, but it's going to be 15 in our case. And then the number of characters actually isn't fixed in this situation, right? Flux capacitor has a different number of characters than hoverboard, which has a different number of characters than Gray's Sports Almanac. So we can't use a fixed number here that matches the number of characters for each item name. So one workaround here is you can just pick a large number that you know will never be exceeded. So let's just do 1,000 here. Excel's not going to return any more characters once it comes to the end of the text string. So if we close our parentheses there, it's only going to return a flux capacitor, and it's not going to return anything else. There's no spaces or anything like that after this. And then we can just pull that down, and it's going to return the full item name. One other thing that you can do if you don't want to type in some large number here, you can use a function called len, which stands for length. So it's going to return the number of characters of a cell. So if you select A2 right there, then it would return the specific number of characters. So you hit enter, and that way you're not having to pick some arbitrary number, but you know that the number of characters isn't going to be less than the total number of characters in the text string. So that's the basic foundation of the mid function. You can do a lot more things with the mid function when you combine it with other functions, but we'll stop here and save it for another video. Thanks for watching, and until next time, go spreadsheet something awesome.